this is where like photography, videography, cinematography, all that shit comes in. We'll start off with the camera focal length, because that's an important one, and framing. So focal length is basically your thing here. And this, you can, I don't know what the best way to describe this is. Usually, if you want something that looks professional, you want to go for a more compressed focal length, so maybe 50 or 80 millimeters. The reason being is in real photography, in the real photography world, cameras with cameras with longer focal lengths tend to be more expensive. Therefore, if you have a camera with a longer focal length, it'll look higher quality or more of production value. That doesn't necessarily mean it's true. You can make commercials with a super wide angle lens if you want to, but generally if you have something that's more compressed, your brain associates it with something more expensive. But that's not the only reason why you would use like a different focal length. Like sometimes I'll use a 50 millimeter or even a 35, but it also depends on how compressed you want your object to be and how compressed the background you want to be. So it depends on how much you want to show the background. So if we were going for like a 35 and we wanted the laptop to be the same distance to the camera, because we want this laptop to fill up the frame, we don't want this laptop to be so far away like this. If it was 35 millimeter, we'd have to make this thing very close, but you can see how much of the environment you can see. So both, you can see a lot of the environment, but also this laptop, if it's angled wrong or a different way, it looks very long and stretched, whereas in this case it's kind of more compressed. It looks more compressed. So here you can see how much more of the background you can see versus this, and also how long this background looks, where here everything looks more compressed and closer together. So if you wanted this laptop to fill out the same amount of frame, but you had a longer focal length, you would have to make your radius wider. And here you can see how much more compressed everything looks. So the laptop is still filling the same amount of frame, but there's less of the background. This will also affect your depth of field, the more compressed the lens. So when I say compressed, I mean basically the higher this number is, or the longer your lens is, the more depth of field you'll get. So the more background blur you'll get, but also the way the scene appears here, the whole background seems like it's moving fast because we have a very compressed lens. So you can get different effects like this. So you can get the effect of the background kind of spinning by while the laptop's moving slowly, so it helps you focus on the laptop as well. Versus if we had a very wide angle lens, like a 25 millimeter, and we wanted this thing to still fill the frame, we'd need to get closer. And here you can see how much slower the background and everything appears to be moving, just because we can see a lot more of it and the lens isn't as compressed. But here everything looks a lot slower, and all we've done is just really change this focal length. So if I went for a like 135, which is quite a long lens, and zoomed out here, you'll see how the background appears to be zipping by because of the focal length. So that's about focal lengths. Like usually if you want close-up views of your object, you go for something more compressed. So here is more of a compressed lens. Here is also compressed to make the background seem like it's whizzing by, so you focus more on the laptop. When you're animating your focus of your camera, a cool thing to do